Welcome back to another Literalist reaction video. I'm Dave. With me, as always, my good buddy, music lover, John Doe. John.
Dave.
You're going today into a wheelhouse that I do actually love, but I have not heard this one. So I'm kind of excited.
We've discussed before that, you know, we're heading to Queen land, and your knowledge of Queen pretty much is Queen's greatest hits.
My knowledge of Queen is entirely Queen's greatest hits. That was the album that I have heard from Queen.
Right. So there's a boatload of songs that they did that does not qualify as greatest hits, but does not make it ungreat music. It's wonderful music. This particular song I have long enjoyed. I think I have an understanding of the lyrics, but I don't know the lyrics very well because I never know the lyrics very well. So this will be a fun experience for the two of us. This is a lyric video from the Queen official website on YouTube. So let's hear a song called Death on Two Legs, dedicated to dot, dot, dot.
All right, here we go. Start subtle. A couple of notes. First of all, I love the opening because it's so surprising. Like, you have this beautiful piano piece that transfers into this like discordant mess of guitar noises that right. then transforms into an excellent sounding song. So I really like how that transfer took place. Like, that was a really neat way to do the opening of a song, to really just take the listener on this journey of surprises. So I really liked that a lot. The lyrics, wow. Until in the very beginning of the song, I was pretty firm in my belief that it sounded like a divorce song, because it sounded like, and I don't know much about Freddie Mercury or whoever wrote this song, but it sounded like they were with someone for a while, and the relationship went very bad, and then that person probably divorced them and took a large chunk of their money. That's what it started to sound like as we went through the lyrics. And then as we continued through the lyrics, now I don't think it is about a personal relationship. I think it is closer to a business relationship like this one, Talk Like a Big Business Tycoon. It almost sounds more like it's like an agent or the record label that was screwing them over and or making them upset in some way. So I think that's where I've landed now at this point in the song, that I think this is a scathing review of most likely either an agent or a record label exec that they really, really hate to the point that they wish for him to commit suicide.
Mm, yeah, that was rough, wasn't it? Yeah. But yeah, Freddie Mercury penned this one all on his lonesome.
Well, he was pissed at someone. So I'll say about this one. Just a hot air balloon. And that's just it. It just ends.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then again, it rolls right into the next song on the track, and it wouldn't be unusual for FM radio to have continued.
Gotcha.
But in this context, since there was enough of a break, we break.
Man.
The first time I heard that song was on their live album called Queen Live Killers.
That was an experience.
Yeah. Yeah. You pretty much had summed it up already. Did you have anything to add to your literalist view of those lyrics?
No, I completely agree with my summation. And I think that he didn't add anything new for the last minute plus of the song.
Just a couple more insults.
All he did was continue to insult this guy that he clearly hates. This, it definitely just sounds like I have no idea what the backstory is here, but clearly there was some sort of business dealings with someone who it turns out was an absolute backstabber. And he's very, very angry about it.
Yeah.
Colorful language, well, though. I'll get mad.
I'll read from, you know, the information that lies before me. Freddie Mercury was talking about the band's fallout with their original manager.
Okay.
And Trident Studios owner Norman Sheffield. It makes no direct reference to him. And Sheffield sued the band and the record label for defamation as a result of this song.
But they never said his name.
It resulted, though, in an out-of-court settlement, so very clearly he was the target of this song. Further down here in the writings, Freddie Mercury recalled that he tried to make the lyrics as coarse as possible and that the other band members were initially shocked at the harsh lyrics. However, they agreed that the song should be performed as he wrote it.
Okay, good for them.
That's how they did it. It's just a great song. It's got some great, interesting guitar parts on it. Some neat off-time stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Some neat breaks and change-ups. And, you know, 1975, buddy. 1975.
I got to say, they did a fantastic job. And once again, you had so many different styles in that piece because you had this classical piano intro, very Freddie Mercury style. And then you moved on to that strange just cacophony of noise that transitioned into the song. And then you did have some time changes. You had multiple different styles throughout. But then you had the same messaging. Like, the messaging was on point. I hate this dude. Messaging was very much, that dude's, I hate him.
Right.
Super, super fun song. Weird lyrically. But you know what? I'd still listen to it again.
There you go.
I think, I think at the end of the day, it reminded me very much of, you know, your mother was a hamster and your father smelled of elderberries, but put to song. That's what it was.
What can one say?
Mm,
Queen's got a lot of neat, fun stuff, especially in the early days when an album could have had seven different genres of music on it. So we've got a lot to go with Queen. And if you happy subscribers would like to leave your Queen recommendations below, we'll appreciate it. We'll add to the list. And I play favorites over the ones that seem to get mentioned the most. So do that, would you? And if you're not subscribed, as a good 97% of you are not, what's the problem? If you have too many, drop a different one and pick us up.
I don't know. Clicking buttons is hard, John. I run this thing, and I click the wrong button all the time, so I will personally vouch for that.
Okay. Well, carefully get Mom to come alongside you, good subscriber, and help you make your mouse click the subscribe button.
That might make it worse for a lot of people.